back? Would you take, would you give my back? Would you take my car when I start to crack? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me when I'm by myself? When I need your love, if I need your love. G'day everybody, my name's Kai, the creator of Elixr Mods, and the last... Why would I say last? There's still so much more to do. Alright, so today's video, today's maybe second, third, I don't know. It's been a long day. This video today, we're going to cover referencing another mod in your own mod pack. So this one today that we're going to be using is one of my own die packs. This is a pack that I made that introduces dies into the game, which allows an additional... item that's got to be made to make other items. Now this is actually used in a few of my other mods, specifically anybody who's familiar with it, my colored glass, the colored building glass for eco. This, the die kit is actually used with that, so you can make your dies and then make your colored glass and stuff. Now I did do an update to it where I changed how much it costs, added some more balances to it and more output, because it was really expensive to make apparently to begin with, but I've done a lot of balancing. Hopefully it's much better, and I've updated the how to use it in your kit with the names and everything like that for 9.0, so this stuff won't actually work in 8.3. so we're only really focusing on 9 at the moment, because eco is just moving forward, we're not looking back. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to download the die pack from the forum. There'll be a link in the description to download. So we're going to download that. Now, for anybody who wants to use this particular pack in their kit, if your person that's going to be using your pack already uses the Elixr Mods stuff, this is included default in the Elixr Mods pack as labeled here. Now this kit here is out of date. This is my full kit, which has like everything we've made in it, like everything that includes the die kit. So if it's already in, like if they already have like the Windows and stuff in their server, then they don't need this extra one. So you can literally just say, look, you're gonna have to download this. You can supply it with your own mod pack. Just make sure you add the notes in your installation instructions. If you use the Elixr mod pack with the die kit, then don't include this in there. But that's up to you whether you want to actually use this one specifically. So all we actually really need as a modder from the die kit is the emdies.dll. We don't need the assets, but if you want to release it with it, feel free. Just make sure you put a reference into the die kit page that will be in the description, just so people can read up on it and get a bit of an idea on what's actually in the kit. So we're just going to grab the EM Dies kit, and I'm going to create a new folder here. I'm going to call it My Mod Extensions. I can't even spell today. I'm just going to call it My Mod EXT because I'm really bad today. Alright, so we're going to open up our Visual Studios where we created our original item, our little table. If you've been following this little series to begin with, then you'll know the table that we've made, and we're going to be actually adding a die to this table, like for the cost. So what we're going to do to start using it is, in the very, very first video when we were setting up, we added references to these, but I didn't actually show you the full steps into adding the references. So what we're going to do is you right click dependencies, we're going to add a project reference, and then we're going to click browse. And then we're going to browse, we're going to go look for our actual DLLs that we need to reference. So wherever you might have installed them is where you're going to want to go, and you can select more than one, so you can select a whole lot if you want, or you can just select a specific one that you're missing. But right now, we're just going to get the emdies.dll. We're going to add this reference, and we're going to click OK. So now the emdies is referenced. It doesn't need the EM framework or anything. emdies is a standalone little pack. But now we can start actually using this in our little mods. So let's say ingredient element type of Brown dye item. See, that's a new item that's not actually in the default eco or anything like that, but it is a part of the ecomods.texture namespace. So you don't need to add any extra usings or references. You just start adding it in as an ingredient element. And let's just say we want to use one brown dye for our table, just so we can dye the wood or whatever. If you've got a different colored texture, whatever color you want. We can also add in new ingredient element type of, and then we can add a bucket of water. So I don't know why you want to add a bucket of water, but you can add a bucket of water. And we'll make that a static recipe, so it'll only ever use, like, only ever need one bucket of water. And this is recommended when using buckets of water, because it is an actual item. It's not something that you can go and just pick up. I want it to be like that, that you can just go use a bucket to pick up water blocks, but it's a little bit on the annoying side. Now, the problem with buckets of water is a lot of people just think that, you know, it might just throw out an empty bucket or something. It won't. We need to actually specify. I don't even know why it's gone and done that. As a new crafting element. So we specify it as a new crafting element, and we're going to add the bucket item. And we'll just give back however many that they put in. It's actually not needed. So, like, say they put in 5, give them back 5 empty buckets. Now, that's up to you. You can make it so the whole bucket's consumed. That's optional. Some people might complain that they're not getting their buckets back. This just means so they don't have to make a bucket every time. They just get the bucket back. It's an empty bucket. So, if that ever happens, by the way, if you accidentally leave that there, and you can't figure out what's wrong with all this, when you've got your crafting element here, just make sure that there's no comma at the end, unless you're adding in a new one. So when you add a new one, then it should stop its little tantrum. But we're just going to do 1 and 1. And I will do a quick, like, visual test to show you that this actually does work, and actually how to make sure it's all working. Now that we've gone and actually referenced this DLL, we actually now need to build our mod as a DLL, otherwise it will not work. So even if we were to put, I'll show you the differences. So we've got our mod folder here, and we have our eco server folder here. All right, so we go in, we replace our CS file. And we need to go and get our die kit. And we just put that whole thing into the eco server folder. Bam, there it is. Now, as I said, I don't need to add it because it's already there. And it will just cause problems. So we just go ahead and we get rid of that, because it's no longer needed. And then we go ahead and we'll boot up our server. Now, this is the first error we're going to get. It'll try and load the mods, and then it's going to fail. And I'm going to show you the error. Once this is finished with its little tantrum, it'll shut down, and we're going to look in our logs. So here we are, our first log file. Compiled with errors, and here's our errors. So the type or namespace, our brown dye that we used in our recipe could not be found. Are we missing a directive or an assembly reference? Now that's because this CS file that we put in, this one right here, references, so this will open up in Visual Studio's code, references an item that's actually not in the game yet. So this is actually all, this loads up way before the die kit does. So to fix that problem, we just need to get rid of our CS file. Open up our mods folder, go bin, all the way across to our, like, netstandard.txt 2.1, and we just grab the my mod DLL. Grab that, and we put that into the server folder. Go ahead, boot it up. And as you can see, our server actually successfully booted. Or is booting way past that it was before. And as explained, I think it was two videos ago, the loading stages of the server. The best way to make sure that your mod itself has actually been loaded, if you're using a DLL, is it'll show up in here. So as you can see here, loading my mod. And that's exactly what we wanted it to do. So now, our server is up and running, we can quickly jump in. And I forgot to show in the last video that our recipe worked, which I'll do in this video. So we go into our server. There's our little table that we made. And let's give ourselves the workbench, because that's where we... Workbench. There we go. We'll give ourselves the workbench, because that's where we set the recipe to be made. We'll have a look, and we just need to look for our little... here it is. There we go. My item. So as you can see, our recipe is in fact here. Uses a bucket of water and... one brown dye that we added in today, and then the original stuff that we set, so some plant fibers and our wood, and then 250 labor, which is 50 cal, so 50 calories or 250 labor, just to make our little table. Now, as I said, the icon, it doesn't look anything like it, it's just a little demo icon that you can use to test, but there's our little table. And if we give ourselves the stuff to make it, so we need one bucket of water, we need one brown dye, Fifteen plant fibers, and five any kind of wood. So we'll just give ourselves some birch log, five. Alright, now we have all the materials that we need to make a little table. Where did it go? There we go. So we'll put in an order, and then we put in our work. And it's going to take 7 minutes to make. I'm not going to make you wait around 7 minutes for it to be made. So I'm just going to cut the video here. And then we'll come back like when it's got like 5 seconds to be made or something. Alright, and we are back. And we, as you can see, we've got about 10 seconds left on the clock. So once this is finished, we're going to collect our item. And we're just going to make sure that it gives us what it's supposed to give us. So we're expecting at least an empty bucket. And our table. So if we click collect, we received one item and one wood bucket. Now I can't see the bucket in my inventory, but it's gone into my backpack. So that's good. So, and now as you can see, we got our new table, we can put it down, and there is our little table. And so yeah. And that's altering recipes and also adding in usages of other mods. And that's what we're going to do for today. So I'm not 100% what I'm going to do for the next video. I might end up doing one of the requested videos, which was advanced server configuration explanation. So explaining the server GUI, what each part is, going through parts inside of it, just for a little bit of more in-depth usage for server owners and stuff. But so that's it for today's tutorial for referencing other mods in your own little mod pack and then using the items inside. So as I said, it's best to do this inside Visual Studios. And unless the item is also SCS, you won't need to reference it like we have here. You'll literally just be able to, like, just make sure that its namespace is the same. It was like eco.mods.techtree, and then you should just be able to reference the item straight up. Otherwise, you'll need to reference it into a DLL. Alright guys, thank you, and I'll see you in the next video.